Hi CrossFit Clan, mobility time again, promised lacrosse ball. We're working on the hips as your primary mover. Being sat down causes those tissues to really get mashed down and jumped up. You can use a lacrosse ball or you can use the yoga tune-up alpha ball. This one's actually my preferred one. Okay, the first thing we're looking at is the hip. We can use either or. Preferred one, the alpha ball, or the good old traditional lacrosse ball. If you're starting out, this is probably kinder, but this one is going to be your go-to one at the end of the day. What we do first of all, down on the floor, you're going to take your ball and you're going to put it into your butt. You're going to hunt around here now until you find that moment, okay? The muscle we're after is a small pear-shaped muscle called the piriformis. You can thank the Greeks for the name of that. Okay, it sits below or sits inside the hip behind the glute max. Okay, and what we're trying to do is we're just trying to let that ball sink deeper into your butt, as deep as it will go. If you're having problems with that and you find that your butt is twitching away, spasming, squeeze your butt off as tight as you can. Hold it for a count of five. Take a big deep breath whilst you've still got the pressure on. And then let the breath out. And as you do let the breath out, relax the butt cheek, and you'll find that the ball will work its way deeper into the tissue. You might need to do that a couple of times, so give that a good go, okay? Once you've got the butt cheek settled down, slightly raise your butt off the ball and turn the foot internally with a straight leg. What that does is it shortens the muscle and it allows you to pin it down. What you're going to do next is sit back down on the ball, so you've pinned it, and you're going to externally rotate your leg by turning your toe outside, and that then stretches the muscle off. Okay, so this is soft tissue release. Lift up, internally rotate, sit back down, externally rotate. Do that 4 to 5 times, and you're good to go. As I said, you can use the lacrosse ball, or you can use the alpha ball. Make sure you do both sides. Otherwise, you'll be walking around in circles for the rest of the day. Even up and balance. That's the message on this particular mobility drill. Okay, we're now off the floor and we're going to use the wall. This one, we're working on the crest of the hip. We're moving across the glute max, the glute medius, and the glute minimus. It's more important for the two side muscles, the mid and the min, because those guys, they come and feed into the TFL, the tensor fascia lata, which is either a Starbucks coffee or Transport for London. That feeds in to the IT band, which feeds all the way down into your knee. Why is that important? It's important because it's part of our torque capturing mechanism. As we squat, the knees are going out, and they're gathering up all that free energy on the descent into a squat. We're using that to come back and recover out of the hole with free energy. That is capturing nothing, that is bleeding out your torque. But to be able to keep your knees out, you need to activate these guys up here. If you're sitting down for long periods during the day, these muscles can't figure out what they're supposed to be doing. And that's why you do see a lot of valgus knees. Next time you're in town and you're walking down the high street, just have a look at the number of people who walk like this. And that is those two guys at the side just not working anymore. They don't know how to work properly. So what we're trying to do is re-engage those muscles and make them sensible again. Again, two options. You've got the lacrosse ball, you've got the yoga tune-up alpha ball. We'll use the alpha ball this time. You're going to put the ball high on the crest. Stand still. The crest of the hip, and you're going to bring it across to the top of the hip joint. Okay? We do this by taking a couple of foot lengths away from the wall, bending our knees, and then sitting back into the wall. Okay? Test and adjust on that. Then you're going to strip across those bands of muscles, those three specific muscles, all the way across until you come over the top of the head of the thigh bone going into the hip junction. Okay? Push this through again. You probably need to do this maybe half a dozen times of stripping,
you'll find that the margins, the border between the glute max and medius, is a pretty gungy spot. And again, smack dab in the middle of the minimus and the medius, you'll find another tight spot in there. It's usually where the muscles butt up to each other, but they don't go too well. Things like hydration helps. So yeah, just get in there with the ball. Whenever you get a really hot spot, don't skip over it. Spend some time sat on top of it. You can do the five count, you can contract it. Big deep breath, relax, and then move on to the next gnarly spot. As I say, do this five or six times, and you'll find that your hips start to move the way they're supposed to. That's it for today, clan. The hips. Leave comments at the bottom of the video. If you like what you're seeing, leave us a review, 5 stars of course. Nip over to our Instagram account and have a look at the stuff we're doing there. And by all means, come across to the website as well and book yourself in for a free session.
This is Wee Jock Poopong McBlop signing off.